Hello, I'm Debra Holt, and this is Lifestreams. I'm so glad you joined us today. So get comfortable. I have a very exciting guest for you to meet, Pamela Hammonds. Pamela, thank you for coming.
Well, thank you, Debra, for inviting me. Yeah, I feel
welcome.
Blessed.
You're welcome. Well, I'm excited. Pamela's a new friend of mine, and we just met not too long ago, and I'm excited for you to kind of get to know her a little bit, too. She's the founder of Restoring the Visions Ministry, and she is raising up prayer warriors, and she's the author of Ridge Runner Trail, which is a prophetic newsletter, and that is releasing decrees to take back the land. She's commissioned under Apostle Chuck Pierce. And Pamela, you just got a lot of experience, 20 years experience out there doing healing and deliverance ministry. Is that correct?
That's correct. Yes.
That is an exciting thing to me because I've seen so much healing in the body of Christ and deliverance, and it just radically changes lives.
It does. It does. And that's what we're all about. We're all about families.
That's
and
awesome.
So, you know, that's one of the reasons why, you know, I like Chicago, because all at once I have a family here.
That's awesome.
And God's just opened up some opportunities for me to come in and just meet some really, really great people. And so it's been exciting.
Well, giving you a little more information about that, we just finished Chicago Worship. Mm-hmm. And it was in Millennium Park, and we just did that last weekend, and Pamela was largely, you know, involved in helping organize all of that. Now, you worked with Roderick and Angela Williams, right?
Correct,
and,
yes.
And their apostolic center is kind of right in the heart of the city, isn't it?
Yes, it's off of Wells Street down there, and they're doing a work, and this was the first year that Chicago Worship was launched, and I have to say,
wow,
it was a success.
It was a great success.
So we were real excited about that.
Now, you are great, obviously, at organizing, because I watched that thing come together so beautifully, and great turnout. I was just really pleased for a first year event.
Mm-hmm.
I was really, really pleased.
Yes.
It was kind of neat. They just had a big tent and advertised this to just everywhere they could get the word out to. Now, Dutch Sheets and Chuck Pierce were there.
Correct.
And Alberta and Kimberly Rivera did some worship there, along with a lot of other worship teams. I thought that was pretty exciting how they brought in so many different worship teams.
Right. And I love the Native Americans.
Oh,
my gosh.
Awesome.
They were awesome. And so Nigel Big Pond, he came, and we just felt honored to have him with us there in Chicago. And there was such a release of, you know, one of the words that had come forth was that as Chicago goes, so shall the rest of the nation. And so what we really saw and felt as we were in prayer is that, you know, that Chicago has the eye of the nation. It is actually you know, the one that is leading the way. It's the one that, you know, is out there. So we really want to, you know, come in and support what's going on here and what God is doing, because how many knows? He knows more than we do.
And well, that's
so,
for sure.
And when we get into his plan, you know, we're going to prosper. And so that was one of the words that had come through Kathy Holcomb about this being the eye of the nation. So it was very critical that we, you know, stayed on that path and we continued mm-hmm. to do what the Lord was telling us to do. And so they've already got a date for next year.
That's great.
And so this is something that's going to be ongoing that the Lord has given them. And what I found that was really neat about it is this was the first time that there had actually been like a gospel worship group in Millennium Park.
I heard him say that.
That was pretty exciting.
And so I was
like, okay,
this is good.
Yes.
Yeah.
So
that will send a reverberating sound through the city.
Yes.
You know, the first time that you release something like that in
yes.
the heart of the city. That's That's amazing. Now, we know James Nesbitt has been praying for years for Chicago, and the Heartland Apostolic Prayer Network has been praying. You know, I think it's so awesome when you see the body of Christ, everybody doing their part.
Right.
Everybody doing their part. But I know on the morning prayer call for the state prayer team, I know we have lifted up Chicago a lot. And one of the things that I believe God is really going to shift and shake in the spirit realm is I believe that the revival is going to go out to the hearts of the people, and the shifting of the bloodlines, mm-hmm. and some of those generational difficulties broken.
Right.
And, you know, less violence. We just believe peace and revival, you know, joy of the Lord and peace of the Lord coming to that area. I'm just so excited to see that happen for Chicago.
Oh, yeah. There's a lot of work to be done, but one of the things that I truly believe that the Lord is calling us as leaders is, you know, forgetting those things that are behind. And pressing to the mark, pressing into, you know, there's always a lot of things that we can say, hey, this happened yesterday or that happened, but let's start with what we're going to do. And so that was one of the things that as we were just even looking at the event to say, hey, what went good and what went bad,
yes.
It's like, we all know what those things are, uh-huh. So let's not come to the table with all of that. Let's come to the table with, this is how it's going to work next year. And so I think that sometimes we can get so caught up that we don't realize that we're starting on a negative base. And so we don't want to do that. We want to say, hey,
yeah.
We're going to forget. We're starting over. This is how that we're going to proceed with this. And so I just see a spring of hope, a new mm-hmm. hope for mm-hmm. this area, because I know personally what it's like to be in hopelessness. I had two of my daughters that almost lost to drug overdose. Yeah. And so in that was much, much prayer, and God has been so faithful to us.
Yes,
I'm here to tell you that both of them are now drug-free. I've got two beautiful grandsons, and I found out while I was here in Chicago I'm going to be a grandmother again.
Yay!
So anybody out there that's grandmothers or grandfathers, you know what that's all about.
Yeah.
I don't even
pretty
have
amazing.
To. Yeah. I mean, you know, we just, we live for that next generation.
Mm-hmm.
And so I feel like that's what God is doing. God is awakening us to the next generation, what needs to come forward, that we don't want those gifts to fall to the ground. We don't want those gifts to not be used and utilized in the kingdom of God. And so we have to do something. We have to begin to be those forerunners that go forth, that brings, you know, the youth of this nation that's going to be leading this nation. And so that's been our prayer. That's been, you know, our assignment to make sure that we do the gathering, that we're not just gathering people, but we're gathering the youth, because there's a lot of issues out there.
Yes. Boy, the youth, they are needy. They don't act like they're needy. In fact, it's like the millennials. They just are so confident in, you know, I got this thing, and it really doesn't matter where their boundaries fall. They just believe they got it no matter what they do. It's almost like I sense that they don't think they need mm-hmm. the older generation's direction or the wisdom or the kingdom principles, but they do need it. You know, they do need those kingdom principles. They do need the, you know, and I'm talking across the board, not just the ones that are having drug addiction or problems. All of them. We all need it. We all
right.
need it.
And I think that was something we were talking about this morning, that when we get around people that celebrate us, that pull that gift out of us, that begins to, you know, we begin to feel like, hey, we're wanted. We're celebrated, we're doing this thing right,
yeah.
You know, we can really excel in that stream. And so I really feel that this is a shift in the atmosphere for some of us because, you know, when I was growing up, children were seen and not heard, and, you know.
Yeah, pretty much.
I mean, you know, and that was the generation. And, you know, I'm thankful for my upbringing and my parents and
we were
my
blessed.
Grandparents. Yeah. Yes. But at the same time, you know, we're in a whole different generation now. Mm-hmm. And so we have to learn how to work along beside of them and help them and give them the wisdom when they do get in trouble. Mm-hmm. And so I just see a new leadership rising up in Chicago, and I just see some new faces coming forth, mm-hmm. kind of like some hidden figures. You know, we were talking about that. I love that movie. You know, and that I watched, and it was just like these hidden figures, you know. But they're coming forth. They're starting to come to the forefront. Mm-hmm. You know, people that are gifted and talented in the arts and the music.
That is so true.
And just, you know, things, gifts that have been laying dormant. It's almost like God is just breathing on those people, and you're starting to see that begin to spring up. And so that's exciting
that is so
to
true.
See that.
That is so true. I love what you said about getting in the right stream because I've experienced both. When you are flowing with those that are like-minded and like-spirited and are encouraging, you just, everything just seems like it comes easy.
Right.
And it flows naturally, more naturally spiritually and spiritually naturally. But, you know, finding that's the key, you know.
Right.
And you mentioned that it flows in seasons, too.
Right.
So.
Right.
Finding it and then staying in that season. I just got that anointing oil when I was at Glory of Zion, the times and the seasons, Issachar.
Right.
The oil for the time, knowing the times and seasons. And so I've really been praying about that. Lord, help me to know the times and the seasons. You know?
Well, and that's what I really like about some of the leaders that I have met here. Because what they have done, especially the apostolic networks and some of the prophetic people, you know, that have training centers that are going on, they are starting to see that window of revelation mm-hmm. open up, like, you know, where they know, hey, it's time for this. Mm-hmm. It's time for that. And so mm-hmm. they've been pulling these things in. And so they're kind of the forerunners that have had to be out there and plow the field that has been very hard. You know, the ground has been very hard. The situations have been difficult to deal with. But yet they've not quit. You know, they've broken their picks, they've broken their shovels, but they just keep moving. You know, they just keep moving because mm-hmm. they know that God has a plan for this land, that He has a plan and a purpose, and that in that they're a part of it. So whatever part the Lord has assigned to them, they've been diligent in it. And so when I came in to help, you know, I just felt honored that they welcomed me in, the prayer teams welcomed me in. A lot of the ground they had already covered. Right. But it was just like God was springing up new things.
That's
He
awesome.
Was, you know, because he's always doing something new.
Mm-hmm.
He's always, I mean, it's just infinite. We don't always just learn everything, you know, in one time around the mountain. Sometimes some of us have to go around quite a few times, and then we see another flower, and then we see another, you know, piece of the mountain. We see another river up mm-hmm. there. We see another, and we get a whole different perspective every time we come through. And so I think that's what I like about this state is that there is a mobilization. There are people that have a heart for the city and a heart for what is going on. So if there's people out there that feels like, hey, you know, there's no hope that, you know, Chicago's all of this, and I know it's known for its gangsters and different mm-hmm. things like that, but I'm telling you, there's a whole stream coming in and starting to flow over the city. And I just saw it when I was here, and I was just so excited about that.
And I agree with that. I think there's a lot of cities in Illinois that have raised up prayer teams that are making a difference. I know Cheryl Weaver, Apostle Cheryl Weaver, has a team here in Champaign-Urbana. And I'll get her number at the next interval here, I'll add her phone number, because if you're interested in being part of a prayer team, she has an amazing prayer team right here in Champaign-Urbana, too. And then, of course, you can always connect with us, Lifestreams Indicator, and that number will be on the screen at the end. So, well, talk to me a little bit about where you see us going now. What, you know, it's going to be a new season. We're done with this project, right. And it wasn't just a project. I hate to even call it that. This spiritual shift, I'm going to call
right.
it, because it was definitely a dynamic shift in the
right.
atmosphere. But where do you see us going as far as focus for this between now and next year? Or will that be something that God will just guide you along the way? Or?
Well, I don't think I hear some of the leaders, especially Apostle Rod and Angela, talking about they're already, you know, mobilizing for next year. They're already putting a plan together because, you know, they already see, you know, the difficulties and the things that they had to kind of plow out mm-hmm. for that initial beginning. So, you know, I think that what we're seeing is and praying about is just the streams that need to come together, mm-hmm. that you need those gifts operating together to mm-hmm. where it's a smooth fit. It's you know, that you're moving together, that the trainings start to come. Some of those things that people are lacking, that they've been crying out for, you know, not just church as usual, but
yeah.
the actual training centers that mm-hmm. that we've been talking about in the body of Christ, where people can begin to find out, you know, I mean, the Bible says that He teaches our hands to war and our fingers to fight. And so in this, you know, is a direction of the Holy Spirit, where the Holy Spirit leads us into battle. He leads us into those places, and He begins to teach us, and He teaches us how to war and how to take the land and the things that we have to do. And so in what we have learned as leaders, now it's time to pass that torch. It's time to impart to others and bring others in so that we can begin the training ground that we need for the future, because, you know, the church is not defeated. We're not defeated. I know that there might be some out there that are in situations that look hopeless. There might be some out there that, you know, they've had some death, they've had some situations. But we were talking today, the quicker we submit to the mm-hmm. plan of God or what happens in our life, the mm-hmm. quicker we can move forward mm-hmm. and we can move mm-hmm. out of that death structure back into life, because He's come to give us life, and He's come to give it more abundantly.
And it's kind of like it's something that we don't just go through one time. I saw it described by one person as like a spiral staircase. You know, you go through dying to self in some area, and then you go around, but you're going upward. Mm-hmm. But then pretty soon you go back to that wilderness again, but then you keep going upward. And it's just like God just keeps taking us through those seasons. And, of course, you know, it gets smaller as you go up. It's almost like, you know, gets closer around, closer around, closer around. So you get wiser. We learn, we get wiser.
Right.
We learn how to make the cycle quicker, you know, to get through it. But I don't think we ever stop learning. I don't think
No.
we ever stop, you know.
No.
I just heard a minister say that on the it was a woman speaker, and I don't remember her name. It was someone I'd never seen before. But on the Christian television program, she said, and if you've just come through something and you're feeling like, oh, thank the Lord, I survived mm-hmm. that. I am never going to go through that again. She said, no, you will. It'll be something different, but you will go through something again. But it gets easier as you see that you're going through the wilderness to get through a new kingdom shift, you know, or you go through change to get through a new kingdom shift. So it's not like you're going through the same thing, but we do continue to keep moving upward and, you know, growing, learning.
One of the things I think that we have to understand as a church and a people, you know, where we're at And we're kind of like at this place called Midbar, right in the center. And so what happens is when we're at Midbar, you can either go back to the old, you know, where all of that mm-hmm. you just passed through, or you can come in to the new. And so it's kind of like we've got to cross over out of what I call the spirit of mourning, because what mourning does is mourning takes us down memory lane, and it reminds us of everything that we've lost. It reminds us of every situation that happened to us in the past. It happened, you know, and so it's like a rehearsal, you know, but when you get to this place where you've come through that, then it's like, okay, it's time to cut all that off, and it's time to, you know, sometimes we just have to cut our losses.
You do. Oh, you many have times. To. I've had to cut losses many times.
Yeah, and just
start
over.
And you think you won't ever have to do that again. You think, okay, now I've went through the big test that God gave me, and now I'm going to move forward and, you know, be done with all this stuff. But but it's not permanent. That's what it's like doing laundry, you know. It's just, you think you've, wow, I passed that test with flying colors. I'm really going to do something for the kingdom. And you do. God does take you to, you know, higher heights and greater things. But don't get comfortable there, because you will go through something at some point again.
Right.
You know, now he brings us victory in that. You know,
absolutely. And that's, you know, part of the forming. That's part of the process. And, you know, I think that what I really like and what I'm seeing with some of the leadership here that I've met is the discipleship, that it's beginning, it's starting. You know, there's fathers here. There's people that have a father's heart, where they're truly reaching out and mentoring, you know, young men, young women, people that have been in these hard places. And so as I see the shift, you know, I see the compassion of God and the heart of God, because one of the words that the Lord had given me is that he was going to give us a new stethoscope for Illinois. And I thought, wow, that's interesting, because with a stethoscope, you can almost hear the vibration of his heart, almost like you read about in John, when John would put his head upon, you know, Christ's heart, and he could just hear the very beat of the Lord's heart. And I really think that that's what God is trying to do here in this state. He's trying to get the heartbeat of the nation. Because as Chicago goes, so does the rest of the nation. And so if we can get some of those things turned around here, you know, and this is such a busy city. I mean, oh my goodness. You know, I was just amazed at the, where I come from, we have mountains, you know. And so,
tell them
but
where you're from, because we didn't
I'm
that.
From Corbin, Kentucky. And so I'm right in the Appalachian region,
that's,
you know,
awesome.
Where Daniel Boone first came across and all of that. So
cool.
So we're pioneers. We're out there pioneering this land. And so I come and I see these big skyscrapers, you know, in downtown Chicago.
Yeah.
And it was just, it was breathtaking. And I just fell in love with it, because it has its own signature. It, every building has its own personality. So I was really, really blessed to come into the city, be able to walk the city, pray over the city, be a part of what God is doing. And I just want to personally thank all of the prayer warriors across the state that came in and helped with the event. Apostle Rod and Angela wanted to say thank you also. And so just know that, you know, it's made a difference.
I do believe it. You could feel a shift from the time we arrived in Chicago when we were done with that worship, you know, time. Oh, my goodness. What a difference. What a difference. It was powerful. Very, very powerful. You know, it's just so beautiful when the body of Christ can come together like that.
Yes.
And what was so cool was there was Hispanics, there was African American. It was kind of like, to me, this is what heaven's going to be like, because everybody was just coming together right. for one purpose, and we didn't care. Nobody, we love each other. We don't care whether you're Indian, you know, the first people, whether you're African American, whether you're Hispanic, whether you're, you know, anything else. Chinese, mm-hmm. there was some Chinese, you know. But it was really neat to see the headsets. The Hispanic people were able to put headsets on and hear the worship or the speaking right. in their own language. I thought, that is just so awesome. Whoever set that up was pretty amazing.
Right. Well, Miss yeah. Angela, she actually has that gifting.
Wow.
And so she was very, very detailed and did an awesome job. And I just, you know, I just applaud them. They really went way out. And
why don't you give them the address and their name of their ministry and their address one more time, so that if someone's going to Chicago and you'd mm-hmm. like to hook up with some Christians up there and go to one of their services on a weekend, you could do that.
Okay, it's Chicago Apostolic Center, and it's 111 North Wells Street, and that's Chicago 60610. And so I think they meet on Saturday evenings at 6. And so just, you know, drop in and visit them there. They'd love to see you, and just let them know.
They probably have a Facebook page or
website. Yes, they do. And
so
it's Chicago.
You can look on their website, yeah. too, if you want to, you know, find out more detail, the midweek service or anything, if they have that.
Right.
But, yeah, it's Apostle Roderick and Angela Williams,
yes.
right?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah, that they were neat to meet. They were neat
yeah.
people. Very
yeah,
awesome people. I enjoy being around them, what little part I was able to be around them. Well, if you could give just, we got just a few minutes left here. If you could just speak over the people one thing, what would you like to say to the people watching, Pamela?
Well, I would just like to say that, you know, I believe that the Holy Spirit, that a wind, a fresh wind is blowing over your state. So I just want you to be encouraged and just embrace that wind of revelation. I feel like that the Holy Spirit is coming, and He wants to knock on every door, and He's hearing our prayers, you know, because His ear is open to the cry of the righteous, and He always hears our prayers. And we were talking about that. Sometimes we feel this resistance. Sometimes we feel like, you know, God's not there. But I'm here to tell you that there is a move of the Spirit of the Living God here in Illinois, and it's moving all over. And so I just want you to be encouraged. I want you to tap into that stream. I want you to get connected. So just, you know, just begin to, she's got some numbers, and if you're out there and you feel like you don't have a place, you know, we can help you find that place. So
yes.
just be blessed and just know that we are praying for you and your families.
Amen. That is so true. Well, yes, I'm Debra Holt, and my number will be at the end. So feel free to call me if you want to hook up with other prayer warriors. And maybe you're out there and you've never started your journey with the Lord, Jesus Christ. But you can do that right where you are. Just ask Jesus to come into your heart and forgive you of where you've missed the mark, and that you want to walk with Him in this journey and then reign with Him in heaven when this life is over. And that's very simple to do. Just start that communication with Him and accept His payment is for you, not just for everybody else. Well, we love you. We bless you. Feel free to call us for anything that you need help with. And Pamela, thank you so much.
Well, thank you guys for having me.
I really enjoyed, you know, hearing what you had to share. And so we love you. We bless you. And we will see you again next week on Lifestreams. God bless you.
See ya.